The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners
now, and at the hour of our death. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the word was made flesh.
And dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may enjoy the blessed consolations.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, made by his passion and cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain with us always, and may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
All peoples, clap your hands, cry to God with shouts of joy. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning,
all peoples, clap your hands, cry to God with shouts of joy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
So welcome you to Mass, the anticipated Mass of Sunday, the 13th Sunday in ordinary time in year A. And we're offering our Mass for the repose of the soul of Teresa Vincent. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for the glorious glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
From the second book of the Kings. One day, as Elisha was on his way to Shunem, a woman of rank who lived there pressed him to stay and eat there. After this, he always broke his journey for a meal when he passed that way. She said to her husband, "Look, I am sure a man who is constantly passing our way must be a holy man of God. Let us build him a small room on the roof and put him in a bed in it and a table and chair and lamp. Whenever he comes to us, he can rest there." One day, when he came, he retired to the upper room and lay down. "What can be done for her?" he asked. Gehazi, his servant, answered, "Well, she has no son, and her husband is old." Elisha said, "Call her." The servant called her, and she stood at the door. This time,
as follows. Anyone who prefers father or mother to me is not worthy of me. Anyone who prefers son or daughter to me is not worthy of me. Anyone who does not take his cross and follow in my footsteps is not worthy of me. Anyone who finds his life will lose it. Anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. Anyone who welcomes you welcomes me. And those who welcome me welcome the one who sent me. Anyone who welcomes a prophet because he is a prophet will have a prophet's reward. And anyone who welcomes a holy man because he is a holy man will have a holy man's reward. If anyone gives so much as a cup of cold water to one of these little ones because he is a disciple, then I tell you solemnly, he will most certainly not lose his reward.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Recently, within the last two or three weeks, I think it was, Archbishop Miguel Buenda, probably haven't said that right, the new papal nuncio in the United Kingdom, presented his credentials to His Majesty the King and was appointed to the court of St. James as the Vatican's ambassador to the UK. Hopefully, this means that there will be no further delay in the appointment in a new Archbishop of Westminster, as Cardinal Nicholls is now 2 years over the mandatory retirement age of 75. I'm sure he must be ready for his retirement. Often, quite often in fact, we must provide identification to prove our identity. But what if we had to prove our status as holy men or women? Would people see in us an authentic discipleship? Would they see that we've been granted a radical share in the threefold office of being priests, prophets, and kings? And if we were dragged before the court for the crime of being a Christian, would there actually be sufficient evidence to convict us? There's something for our examination of conscience. In Elisha's time, the people's faith is disrupted, so the prophet becomes an itinerant preacher, taking shelter where he could. The woman recognizes his credentials as a holy man of God, welcoming him, providing him with nourishment. And Elisha will reward her for her hospitality. He will bless her with the gift of motherhood. And when tragedy strikes, he will raise her son to new life. In this most holy mass, the Holy One of God is passing by, and we make room for him in our souls. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under our roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. In welcoming the Lord, we are rewarded with infinite blessings, the graces needed for reaching eternal life. As St. Paul reminds us, the life of grace was given in holy baptism, when we died with Christ and rose with him to new life. The outward sign of the inward grace in baptism is the washing away of sin and our rebirth as a child of God. In going under the water, we die with Christ, and coming out of the water, we rise with Christ to everlasting life. Hence why the font is called Tomb and Mother. Yes, baptism at the church font has become the norm. But this image might be clearer if we march down Sea Road and baptize people in the sea. Unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on your viewpoint, it's never quite warm enough. But in the parish church in particular, it's very important that the font is visible and has a position of prominence, not stuck in the corner of the sanctuary and moved every time we want a baptism, as if it's not really that important. No, the font must be prominent because it all flows for us from baptism. Now that we have died with Christ, we no longer fear the consequences of death. Even though we are dust, and unto dust we shall return, but our souls still have now the assurance of eternal life. Indeed, we confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, which imparts a new indelible character that enables us to share in the life of Christ now and for eternity, giving us that identity of being a Christian. Now, this does not mean we are unconcerned with how we die, and there remains that great Catholic tradition of praying for a happy death. Now, for lots of people, happy death is in the armchair with the cricket on in the background, England beating the Ashes, giving the Ashes in Australia. Unlikely. But it's really, a happy death really means being free from sin, surrounded by our family, in communion with the church. All of us share the responsibility too of cherishing life from conception through to natural death. That's an activity consistent with the baptized who have been moved out of darkness into God's wonderful light. And even in death, we still proclaim the resurrection of the body on the last day. And even if we've been cremated, our ashes should have a final resting place, because we pray that from the earth, God will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. Then we shall enjoy the fullness of redemption, where God will be all in all, and we shall take our place in the new heaven and the new earth to come. Don't ask me what the new heaven and new earth looks like. It hasn't happened yet. But all we do know is it will be the time when God shall live with his people. This will be a time when God will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing God as he really is, we shall be like him for all the ages and praise him without end. Through Christ our Lord, for whom he bestows on the world all that is good.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for us salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess from baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, when we were baptized, we went into the tomb of Christ so that we too might live a new life. And so we pray.
For the church, called to make disciples of all the nations, may the baptized continue to pick up their cross daily and follow us. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those preparing for baptism or considering the call to repentance, may we remain dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who are preparing for their final weeks of the school year, may those moving on to new challenges trust in the Lord for their future. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For vocations to the priesthood, the diaconate, and the religious. May the Lord raise up many holy people to his service. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the sick, the housebound, the lonely, the bereaved, and all those in need, may they, through the church, sing forever of your love. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who have died, and those with anniversaries at this time, may they be reassured that your love, O Lord, lasts forever. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
May our Lady of the Rosary pray for us and with us as we say, Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
In a moment of silence, we pray for our own needs and intentions.
Almighty Father, you have called us out of darkness, illuminating us with the truth of the gospel, and so we ask to hear and answer our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work in your hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and his all and his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, be with you. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the
Holy Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance
inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Teresa, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up from the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the passing of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind remittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through heaven with heaven and heaven, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
We dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious is our peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God, forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and let us see on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice which we offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So, following on from Thursday's holy day of obligation for Peter and Paul, the retiring collection this evening is the annual collection for Peter's pence, which funds the Holy Father's missionary endeavour. It may still be called Peter's pence, but I don't think the Holy Father expects you to take that literally and only put pence in. There are no weekday masses this week, Monday to Friday. I'll be on retreat at the Edinburgh Oratory with Father Gerard Cutter. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Ave.